My favorite thing about Beach Project is being around so many other people my age who truly love God and who want to grow in their own walks.
Getting to know the girls in my room and really trusting God with opening my heart to them.
The room, your roommates, just getting to know people. Best part.
I would say one of the best parts about Beach Project is definitely group dates. Not only do you meet great godly guys, we get free food, free fun activities, and it's just so much encouragement to be around so many godly men and women that are our brothers and sisters in Christ.
I'm going to push you, I'm going to get in your face, and I'm going to work you like a dog. And when I get finished with you, I guarantee you when you go back to your coaches, they will be impressed.
Well, AIT is athletes in training, and as a participant, you try to get a job that allows you to work maybe 30 to 35 hours a week, so you have time to train. Basically, you're on your own as far as working out is concerned with weights and so forth. Usually, you have an accountability partner.
And you're not going to come back losing weight. You're not going to come back weak. You're going to eat fine. You're going to work out. You're going to be strong. In fact, you'll probably come back even stronger because mentally you're going to be tougher.
We have agility drills, we have sprints, 40 yards, 50 yards, 60 yards, even 110 yard sprints on the beach, and I'm talking about time limits.
Good because I get a chance to work out with other athletes and they're there to encourage me.
For physical training is of some value, but godly training has value in all things.
Housekeeping.
Here at Beach Project, we have a very, very technical jobs, very high paid.
Well, I move around fertilizer and like bags of soil and cow manure and stuff like that.
What I do is I'm a poultry technician. I can grow cheese the way you like it, paper or plastic. Also butter buns, which is an important job.
Well, pushing buggies, you gotta be buff.
I'm a chef.
Where are you a chef?
At McDonald's.
Basically, you just go get the carts that are out in the parking lot and bring them back in and make sure that the store has enough carts going.
A lot of times I'm the egg girl, so that's folded eggs and omelet eggs.
You have to make sure the label's to the front,
and you've got your round eggs,
and every item is to the front of the shell.
And then you got scrambled eggs and burrito eggs, so there's a lot of different eggs.
I say dry grocery stocking is the backbone to a grocery store.
It goes to several different kind of biscuits. You got your sausage, egg, and cheese, your bacon, egg, and cheese.
Trying to decipher between a pound or a pound and a half, that's basically my day.
Your sausage, egg, McMuffin, your egg McMuffin.
Red Boston lettuce, romaine lettuce, escargot lettuce.
And for some reason, people think when they stare at you, you're going to be faster. That's not true.
One thing I do know about being a maid is that if humility is taught, it's learned in the cleaning business.
I have a chance to learn to walk with the creator of the universe, just to get to know him personally, and that he seeks to know me personally, and that he desires for me to grow in ways that I can't even begin to imagine right now.
Well, discipleship is what Christ did. He had 12 men that he invested his life in, and three or four of them that he, really spent most of his time with and invested his life in, and that it's just a process of investing in eternal things and passing on the things you know to people who will be able to pass it on to people that they know, who will pass it on to people that they know.
I've learned leading takes a lot of serving, takes a lot of loving.
The biggest thing I think is learn how to study the Word, because that's something I'm going to be able to do for the rest of my life.
This is the purpose of life, and that's to grow in our relationship.
If you want to grow in your relationship with Christ and you're serious about your relationship with Him, I believe there's no other place that you can get training in how to know God and to make Him known like you can get here.
The Beach Project will challenge your thinking, will cause you to have a desire to want to know God more, to value fellowship in your life, to grow in what it, having a heart for the lost, and I just think all in all will push you forward in your relationship with God.
A month before I had to be here, I started doubting because my parents didn't want me to go, and I saw that I could work somewhere else and make more money. About 2 weeks before project started, I just realized that I was putting my needs higher than God's will. And I knew that if I laid everything over in God's hands, He will take responsibility for what followed.
And basically, if you take time to invest in that relationship with Him for a summer, the results will be incredible because He will change your life.
That's one thing I'm learning, is to become a woman of prayer. And the Bible is how God talks to us, and through prayer, that's how we talk to God.
In the mornings on Beach Project, you will see students all scattered all over the place on the beaches, at the picnic tables, around the pool, spending time in the Word and praying.
Prayer and worship here at Beach Project is off the hook. The reason why I say that is because everyone is into it. They're truly worshiping God. They're not worrying about what this other person next to them is thinking about what they're doing. Their only consideration is they got one audience, and that's God.
Your love, oh Lord, reaches to the heavens. Your faithfulness stretches to the sky. Your righteousness is like the mighty mountain, yeah. And your justice flows like the ocean's tide. And I will lift my voice to worship you. I will find my strength in the shadow of your wings.
Ultimately, we're going to stand before Him and praise Him in heaven, and so our lives are an expression of that.
Today I shared my faith for the first time, shared the gospel for the first time with someone, and she accepted Christ today. It was awesome. Today I got to share my testimony for the first time.
Today I just had a guy pray to see Christ with me.
Just prayed to see Christ and surrendered all to Christ today.
My favorite thing about Project, I guess, would be just seeing people come to know Christ. Seeing God draw people to Himself.
And we take an opportunity to go out onto the beach and maybe we play tug of war, build sandcastles to get a crowd up, and then we take time to build relationships with them and just talk with them about what it means to have a personal relationship with Christ.
I overcame the fear of evangelism by evangelizing.
It's really taught me God's confidence. It's taught me that my success in evangelism doesn't depend on the response of the people I share with. It's totally dependent on I've been faithful to God's command to share the gospel. And the people, I mean, they're so lost, but God has just given me a heart just to love them.
Man, when I come down here, I'm not coming down here just for a little, just for a great summer. I'm coming down here to impact, you know, the people around me in this world for eternity.
I'm going to heaven. I'm going to heaven. I'm going to heaven when I die.
I just think about Mary and Martha, you know, and Martha spent time running around the kitchen doing great things, but Mary sat at Jesus' feet and got to know Him better, and Jesus confirmed that Mary chose what was best. So I just say, choose what's going to allow you to sit at Jesus' feet and know Him better.
Once in a lifetime experience to receive this kind of training.
You just can't help but catch the excitement. You can't help but grow here.
I would do it every year of my life if I could.
Tell me who you are real quick. And
oh man,
Are you going to ask that? Cut! Cut!